I'm Dominic, core developer for Inviwo, and in this video I will show you the basics of the graphical user interface. The goal of this video is to get you familiar with the interface so that you can create workspaces using the existing processors. So let's get started. When you start up Inviwo, you will get prompted with the Getting Started page. On the left-hand side, you can see example workspaces, but we will create our own workspace for this video. To create visualizations in Inviwo, we build a network that represents the different steps in our visualization pipeline, from importing data to actually displaying the results. This network will be built in this main area highlighted here. The basic building blocks of this network are called processors. They can be selected from the list on the left and can just be drag and dropped into the network editor. You can write your own processors, of course, but for now we will stick with the predefined ones. The purpose of a processor is to encapsulate one action that can then be adjusted according to its properties. Each processor has inputs and outputs to receive or produce data, which are depicted by these colored rectangles. The mesh creator has only a single output, which is used to pass the mesh data to the network. To visualize our output, we use the canvas processor. The only input to the canvas is the image to be displayed. As indicated by the colors of these ports, the output of the mesh creator is different than the type of our canvas import. We need another processor to create an image from the mesh. Of course, for this we will use the mesh renderer. Now we can add all the necessary connections. And finally, here we see our rendered image. Also notice that all the green lights pop up for the processors. That means they work correctly. You can now inspect the mesh from different directions by controlling the canvas with your mouse. You can look around by pressing and holding the left mouse button. Also try using the different buttons on your mouse to get an intuition for the trackball. Let's take a closer look at all the ports. First of all, we notice that the type of data that they're transporting is corresponding to their color. For example, yellow encodes meshes and blue encodes images. Second, we notice that the data flows from top to bottom, so the inputs are always on top of the processors, and the outputs are always on the bottom. Some inputs are also marked optional with a small dot. You can inspect most ports in a network by just hovering over them. This will give you a quick preview and some information about the data type. Here we can see the rendered image and additionally the depth layer. Okay, let's talk about properties now. You can select a processor to reveal the property list on the right-hand side. This will let you modify all the relevant settings and parameters for this processor. Selecting the mesh renderer, for example, we can see that there are a lot of properties to tamper with. So let's try to change the light position. Or also let's try to change the light color. Another concept that I want to introduce is the linking of processors. For this, let's extend our workspace to render two meshes separately, but displaying them in the same canvas. Note that those two processors got connected after I dragged the second one in. Inviwo automatically connects processors with properties of the same type to keep them in sync. For example, here we connect the camera, so we always have a synced camera in all of those processors. By default, they synchronize the data in both directions, but you can also change that by clicking on the link. So if we set up everything correctly, we should get an output to the canvas now. You can of course also write this image to a file. Now, for some neat little tricks when working with large amounts of data or the processing is just enormous. Usually, whenever you change something in the network, it will automatically try to compute a new output. But we can switch that behavior off with this button. Another cool thing to handle large networks is to group processors. You can abstract parts of the networks to more high-level tasks. For example, we could reduce our mesh rendering pipeline to just one processor each. Obviously, these benefits get even larger for larger subnetworks, but you get the idea. It reduces complexity and it makes it easier to work with. Okay, let's save this workspace and we're done for this video. If you have any more questions regarding Inviwo, we have documentation linked below, as well as our Slack channel where you can always just ask any questions. Thanks for watching.